The Higher Astral by H.P. Blavatsky. This piece is taken from Volume 3 of The Secret Doctrine, which was posthumously compiled from H.P. Blavatsky's writings and published in 1897. It is read by Dave Marsland of Cardiff Theosophical Society. The Higher Astral. Even in ordinary mediumistic life, so-called, it is pretty well ascertained that while the body is acting, even though only mechanically, or resting in one place, its astral double may be appearing and acting independently in another, and very often distant place. This is quite a common occurrence in mystic life and history, and if this be so with ecstatics, seers and mystics of every description, why cannot the same thing happen on a higher and more spiritually developed plane of existence? Admit the possibility on the lower psychic plane, then why not on the higher plane? In the cases of higher adeptship, when the body is entirely at the command of the inner man, when the spiritual ego is completely reunited with its seventh principle even during the lifetime of the personality, and the astral man or personal ego has become so purified that he has gradually assimilated all the qualities and attributes of the middle nature, buddhi and manas, in their terrestrial aspect, that personal ego substitutes itself, so to say, for the spiritual higher self and is thenceforth capable of living an independent life on earth. When corporeal death takes place, the following mysterious event often happens. As a dharmakaya, a nirvani without remains, entirely free from terrestrial admixture, the spiritual ego cannot return to reincarnate on earth. But in such cases, it is affirmed the personal ego of even a dharmakaya can remain in our sphere as a whole and return to incarnation on earth if need be. For now, it can no longer be subject, like the astral remains of any ordinary man, to gradual dissolution in the Karmaloka, the limbus or purgatory of the Roman Catholic, and the summerland of the spiritualist. It cannot die a second death, as such disintegration is called by Proclus. It has become too holy and pure, no longer by reflected, but its own natural light and spirituality, either to sleep in the unconscious slumber of a lower nirvanic state, or to be dissolved, like any ordinary astral shell, and disappear in its entirety. But in that condition known as nirmanakaya, the nirvani with remains, he can still help humanity. Let me suffer and bear the sins of all, be reincarnated unto new misery, but let the world be saved, was said by Gautama Buddha. An exclamation, the real meaning of which is little understood now by his followers. If I will that he tarry till I come, what is that to thee? Asked the astral Jesus of Peter. Till I come means till I am reincarnated again in a physical body. Yet the Christ of the old crucified body could truly say, I am with my Father and one with him, which did not prevent the astral from taking a form again, nor John from tarrying indeed till his master had come, nor hinder John from failing to recognize him when he did come, or from then opposing him. But in the church, that remark generated the absurd idea of the millennium or chiliasm in its physical sense. Since then, the man of sorrows has returned perchance more than once, unknown to and undiscovered by his blind followers. Since then, also, this grand Son of God has been incessantly and most cruelly crucified daily and hourly by the churches founded in his name. But the apostles, only half initiated, failed to tarry for their master, and not recognizing him, spurned him every time he returned.